Alright guys, this is your boy Dr. Bodak from YouTube. Alright, today what are we going to be reviewing? We're going to be reviewing the Elgato Game Capture HD High Definition Game Recorder. Alright guys, this retails for about $180 online in certain stores and $160. It's around that price range, from $160 to $180 it retails. I got it from B&H Photos Store online or whatever it's called for $157. With tax, it came to $171 with free shipping. So, if you guys want to get it as cheap as possible, I suggest there. I would not buy this used personally, but that's up to you. It's your risk. You can take it. Alright guys, when you get the package, you know, you'll see this fine box, the Game Capture HD High Definition Game Recorder. You'll see on the box, you know, it could record PS3. It could live stream. It has 1080p lag-free HDMI pass-through to the TV. Flashback recording feature to record retroactively. It's a cool feature, but personally I wouldn't use it. One click sharing to YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. I don't use that either. I just upload it manually as USB 2.0 input to 360 PS3, but also it works on Wii U and stuff such as that. Output to HDMI, supported resolutions. It supports from 240p to 1080p. That's a lot of resolutions, you know. That thing is very light. It's like 1 pound almost. It supports Mac OS X 10.7 and later. You need a 2.0 gigahertz processor with at least 2 cores. If you have a 4-core processor, you should be pretty good. My laptop runs a decent. It's like a 1.9 gigahertz processor with 4 cores, 4 gigabyte RAM, and built-in USB 2.0. If you don't have any of that, you kind of out of luck right there. Sorry guys. It comes with the Game Capture HD, a quick start guide, a USB cable, HDMI cable, a PS3 cable, and a component cable. Alright, supports Windows 8, Mac, and all that. Twitch, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, all that jazz. It also has some Spanish stuff for those Latinos. Alright guys, as you see inside the box, what do we have? It's a slide cover, you know, it is just like one piece cardboard cover, you know, fancy stuff. Then you have this book. Doesn't really say anything on it. Has side stuff, has some artwork, looks nice, professional. And then inside it is the Game Capture HD, alright? Game Capture HD, basically what it has is an HDMI out that goes into the TV, a USB that you need to power it, otherwise, you know, you're kind of out of luck. There's an AV in. This is for the PS3 adapter. You need to use this for PS3 and an HDMI in, alright? Other than that, it's pretty slick, sleek. It's kind of lightweight. And seems sturdy enough. I don't really want to bang on it and break the cost a lot of money. And sorry, I have to bleep that because, you know, kids might be watching this, you know, think of the children. And apparently I'm not professional enough on my old YouTube channel, so I will bleep it. All right. Other than that, you know, comes with a quick start guide. I didn't notice this in my unboxing that it's an actual card. I thought it was like a thing. And it gives you instructions how to set it up. These instructions are pretty damn vague. I have to admit, the PS3 took a while to hook up, but the 360 was a piece of cake. But when I say 360, I only hooked up the Wii U, but it seemed quite similar. Also comes in Spanish for the Latinos again. And yeah, you also have to download the software at gamecapture.com/download. Otherwise, you cannot use this thing, all right? In there, there's also other stuff like the wires, HDMI, but you know, you can see that in my unboxing, which I will leave an annotation to, because, you know, I kind of have it hooked up and I really don't want to hook it up again. So, other than that, it's really sleek, lightweight, records very good. I'll show some gameplay footage of it in 1080p recorded in native. Unfortunately, I can't upload it raw because I'm required to render it into this. So the quality might be a little diminished in the sound. But it should be in as good quality as possible because I will upload this in the highest quality possible. Alright guys, this is Dr. Bodak and we are at the desktop download for Game Capture HD. You go over here, this is what the quick start icon looks up. Wow, I'm going crazy. This is professional. I know guys, I'm sorry. Can't be perfect. Nobody's perfect. You know, you live and you learn. Whatever Miley Cyrus says. She's a crazy teenager. I know. I shouldn't be listening to crazy teenagers. But anyway, you're going to wait for the software to load up. And I will skip to it. Alright, once it loads up, you're going to click capture. And you will have a preview of your screen. This is basically the preview of my screen, but since I'm recording, it is not really up to date, but you can see that it does work. Desktop capturing program is really slow. So anyway, basically right here you have your settings. You could change what system you're using. Currently I'm using PS3, so I have PS3 enabled. I could switch to 720, which I generally record in, but for 1080, because this is going to be a review, I have to put the best quality possible because people want to know how good the quality is. But then again, I'm rendering it, so it might be a little diminished. Anyway, this is my picture settings. If you want, you could copy. I think they're pretty good settings myself. Audio, I generally don't mess with a profile. You could save a profile. I have a Wii U profile. CV compatibility, I'm really not sure about that. But if I ever figure out, I'll probably let you guys know and update this video. Who knows? Other than that, you put the game audio higher or lower. You put live commentary. Personally, I want to use this. I would use something like Audacity and record this sound in a different program and then sync it, because you can change the levels of both sounds in Vegas or whatever you're using. So that's what I usually do, but it's kind of hard to sync. So if you want, you could use this setting. It's not bad, but it's not the greatest. Live streaming right here, you know, you could live stream to like Twitch, as the box says. I haven't tried that yet because I'm not really a live streamer, more of a commentator and stuff like that. Game capture HD preferences, you can change the folder. Originally it's in a downloads slash video folder, but I changed it to video slash Elgato, so I know where it is. Enable flashback recording, basically it remembers what you recorded, and you could kind of like, how do you say this, like rewind, and you could save some of your footage. I don't use it because I think it kind of makes my performance worse on it. Always convert videos. I keep MP4 original because I want the highest quality possible. That's like raw. I don't have any share things on because I really don't want it to do it itself. I prefer to upload it the old-fashioned way. Automatically check for software updates. I don't use either. But yeah. So now you could pause your screen, fast forward from here, from the flashback recorder. It also has video editor thing, sort of. If you don't have, if you have flashback on it, I think you could, render it. If you don't have the rendering on, you double click it and we'll re-render it. I already have this Grand Theft Auto thing rendered, so I don't need to do that. And, I'll show some quality. Alright guys, this is some quality from New Super Luigi U. I had to put the game on mute because Nintendo likes to give copyrights, and honestly, I don't feel like getting a copyright on a review that I did for the game. For the captured card. So, quality is pretty damn good if I do say so myself. I was having some issues with it, but it ended up working out. So, here we go guys. This is some test quality of the game. Alright guys, my final thoughts is that, you know, if you want a capture card and you have the money for a really good one, I suggest buying this because it's really good. The Elgato Game Capture HD, I can't recommend it more than enough. It's kind of steep on the price side, but if you want 1080p recording, that's kind of what you have to give out. The cheapest thing you could probably get is a AVerMedia besides that, which is like 120, still pretty steep. I picked the Elgato because I know it's a pretty good brand name, and I know it's sure to work. It hasn't given me any problems, except if you check my Wii U playthrough of Wind Waker HD, I think I kicked the wire during it, and then it accidentally fuzzed it up for a little bit, but other than that, it's pretty good, and I was recording for 40 minutes. I don't think you should record that long, personally. I don't know, maybe it's my issue, but other than that, suggest it, pick it up if you can, and if you like this review, comment, like, subscribe, it helps the channel out.